Hey guys, it's Liv. Welcome back to Temple's YouTube channel. So today I thought we would talk a little bit about food. I know sometimes when people go away to college, they're a little bit concerned about what am I gonna eat? Am I gonna like not like the dining hall food? How am I gonna survive? How am I gonna cook for myself? How am I gonna do this? But I got you covered. So today I thought I'd take you through what I normally eat here at Temple and what some of the different options are. So I personally have an 8-meal meal plan. So I get 8 meals a week and 4 of them can be in a regular dining hall. And then 4 of them I can use as equivalencies in places at the student center. Being so close to the city, besides on campus, there's so many restaurants and places to go to outside of campus. We're so close to Center City, Philadelphia here, so it's really easy to go downtown and go out to eat as well. So the first meal of the day, breakfast today, I went to the Morgan Hall Dining Hall, which is located conveniently in the building that I live in. So it's really simple and easy to walk downstairs and get yourself some breakfast. So to swipe in the dining hall, you use your OWL card. Every student, I believe, gets one, and you just kind of tap in with the people working there, and then you're free to go and get whatever you want to eat in the dining hall. It is like buffet style, I guess, so you can eat as much as you want. So this morning, I got scrambled eggs, I got tater tots, and I also got sausage. The tater tots were really good, I'm not gonna lie. The dining hall normally has pretty good variety of things to eat for breakfast. You know, you got your eggs, omelet station, pancakes, waffles, tater tots, turkey sausage, or turkey bacon, sausage, bunch of different variety of things. So you really can pick and choose what you want to eat. And I know there's different options for those that are like vegan, vegetarian, and all the different dietary restrictions. I think there's also cereal there, but I'm not a big cereal person. Okay. Next meal of the day, I decided to cook my own lunch. I typically like to make my own lunch. The biggest break I have in between my classes is my lunch time. So I get done at 12 and then my next class is at 3. So I got a good chunk of time to get done some work. So I prefer to come home to my dorm and then cook myself lunch and then work on schoolwork at the same time. Also, luckily there is a grocery store super close to my dorm. So I walked around the corner, I went to the grocery store today, and I got some zucchini, a pepper, and some chicken, and I made myself lunch. My personal favorite is going on Pinterest and looking up different recipes and trying them out. It's a fun way to, you know, save money rather than going out to eat all the time and stay a little bit healthier too. Because when you're cooking for yourself, you can decide, you know, what you're cooking, what you're eating, what you're putting into your body. And here I cooked zucchini, some peppers, chicken, and rice. I normally try to like to get in some veggies and some protein. So if you ever get sick of the food in the dining hall or elsewhere, you could always try to make yourself something. It's like a fun little challenge that you can try for yourself. And I think it's just a good life skill in general to have, just learn how to cook for yourself, because eventually you're not gonna have a dining hall to eat at every day. So the next place that I went to for food after my dorm, I met up with some friends and I went to the food trucks, which I went to the ones that were outside of Tyler, the art school. So as a late afternoon snack, I got a crepe. Not sure how you pronounce it, but it tasted good. It was apple and caramel and honey goodness. It was really good. Would 10 out of 10 recommend as like a good pick me up. You know, sometimes late afternoon, you need a little bit of a munchie. So that's what I got as a snack. And you can also go to those food trucks for lunch. There are so many different ones, which I personally love. I think that's something that's really cool and unique to Temple is that we have food trucks here. It's a great perk of being in the city. So finally for dinner, I went to the student center and I got my usual twisted taco burrito bowl. So there at the student center, I used a meal equivalency. And a meal equivalency is basically a meal swipe. So you get a certain amount of dollars per meal. So I think for dinner, it's $8.69. And then if you go over that, you can charge it to your diamond dollars, which is like, basically, you just put money into your account and then you can take it out of there. So say my dinner came to $8.89. I could use a meal equivalency, so $8.69, and then pay the 20 cents in the diamond dollars. Meal equivalencies are a great way to, you know, broaden your horizons of what you're eating and not only eat at the dining hall. So for dinner, I got a bowl at Twisted Taco. I'm not gonna lie, I go there a lot. Probably a little bit more than I should, but I typically get the burrito bowl, so I get rice, and then I get grilled chicken, the queso, which is pretty good, a little bit too good, the queso, and then I get lettuce, pico de gallo, onions, and a little bit of cheese. So that's my typical order at Twisted Taco, so that's what I got today for dinner. Super good. Sorry if lighting changed, I just had to close my blinds because it's getting way too sunny outside. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed seeing what I eat here at Temple University and what the different dining options are. Whether you have a meal plan or not, there's so many different places for students to try out, whether you're cooking in your dorm or going to the dining hall, going to a food truck, or going to a local restaurant. There's so many places to eat here at Temple and just in general in the city of Philadelphia. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Temple University's YouTube channel so you can stay updated on all their upcoming videos. Bye guys.